We're rolling. Ready? Yeah. All right, and action.
Hey, this is Adam here again with another behind the scenes video covering our last Genshin cosplay video featuring Rainy Renton as Klee. Again, please make sure to go check her out on Twitch and her other social media. She's a really awesome and fun artist to get to know. This one we shot at Marymore Park, which had a lot of open fields and tall grass and a windmill, which I felt kind of passed as Mondstadt-y. It's a pretty big park and we shot this during the weekday, so we didn't have much trouble with bystanders walking through, which was awesome. Like all these cosplay cinematics, I like to work in their characteristics from their personalities, mannerisms to their abilities, like their powers that they have in the game, to really try to bring their cosplays even more to life. So for this one, we showed Rainy running around with the airplane arms and being cute and adorable, and Klee being a bit of an explosives fanatic, I wanted to showcase her utilizing her bombs in her favorite way with fish blasting, as well as her using her special abilities. For these shots, I used two different methods of motion tracking. For this shot of her doing a charge attack, I used After Effects 3D Camera Tracker, as it was a fairly simple dolly shot on the gimbal. The tracking data was pretty accurate on this one until towards the end of the shot, but I edited out the parts where the tracking wasn't sticking so well. And for this one, all the elements were planned to be in front of Rainy, so once the tracking was done, compositing elements into the scene was fairly easy and just needed some level and glow adjustments to match the scene. Now, Klee has that magical glyph that has her clover symbol on it that is present in a lot of her special abilities, so I recreated it as best I could in Adobe Illustrator. I'm not an expert in Illustrator, so it wasn't the most intricate or symmetrical picture. The reason I used Illustrator was to make use of the vector-based art, because once you bring it into After Effects and convert it into a shape layer, you can have the layer be as big as you want and not lose any quality if you need to scale it bigger. For the side tracking shot, I used rotoscoping to separate Rainy from the background because I wanted the explosion elements behind her to give the scene more depth. Rotoscoping can be kind of a pain though, and can be kind of a hit and miss with some shots, but I got a pretty clean mask and I was pretty happy to say it was usable. Now, using a green or a blue screen for shots where I plan to have elements behind that talent would be a better idea, but the way I shoot right now is very guerrilla style filmmaking where the focus is to bring minimal equipment for minimal setup time and trying to move through shots as quickly as possible. It's a lot easier to move from location to location with less stuff to carry, and of course I don't want to take too much time from the cosplayers as they've already are kind enough to take time to shoot with me. For the sparks and splash shot or the elemental burst, we had two plush bombs and the cool thing is they fold inside out. So one side had the neutral beige side and the other with the angry face side. So we did the old jump cut switcheroo trick to make it transform to the other, like in what we see in Klee's elemental burst animation. The main shot consisted of me starting from the front, then revolving around Rainy as she walked forward. Since the shot was not as simple as the last, I decided to use Mocha AE for the planar tracking, as I didn't think the default After Effects tracker was going to be too accurate. I was pretty happy also with the way I animated the transformation of the bomb turning into the floating clover, and I was able to tweak the keyframes where I felt it was natural looking. The fish blasting scene was one of my most anticipated scenes to shoot because it's the most Klee thing you can do, but I also wanted to include using this floppy cat toy fish because I thought it'd be a really creative way to work in a practical prop in there. For the water splashing, I didn't want to actually throw a rock into the lake to disturb anything, so I used a stock footage water splash from Action Visual Effects stock library. Then I used Mocha to again separate Rainy from the background to have the splash behind her. Overall, had a great time making this video as always, but that's going to be it for this one. If you want to help support more of these kinds of projects, please like, comment, and subscribe, and be sure to hit that notification bell so you always know when we post new videos. Also, be sure to follow us on our other social media platforms as well. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.